Nascent means incipient, just begun. The antonym should be fully developed. Natation, N-A-T-A-T-I-O-N. Natation means swimming. They're conducting courses in natation, means swimming. Natty means neatly or smartly dressed. Dapper, D-A-P-P-E-R. Dapper means natty or smartly dressed. Nauseate means to cause somebody to become sick, filled with disgust. Nauseating means something that is bilious. Nautical means pertaining to ships or navigation. Navigable means wide and deep enough to allow ships to pass through. Nebulous concepts are very vague, hazy, and cloudy and unclear. So the antonym should be clear. Necromancy means black magic. Hexing, H-E-X-I-N-G. Voodoo, V-O-O-D-O-O. And black magic, witchcraft, and sorcery, S-O-R-C-E-R-Y. Shamamism, S-H-A-M-A-M-I-S-M. A shamam is a wizard who indulges in black magic. Negate means to cancel out, nullify, and deny. Negligence is neglect. Negligible amount means trifling and very small. And nemesis is someone seeking revenge. And nemesis is an opponent who is strong and very feared and the cause of your failure or destruction. Nemesis also means the goddess of punishment. Nemesis is deserved punishment. A neologism means a newly coined word or phrase. For example, some authors, for example, Lewis Carroll. Lewis Carroll created the word Bumbledom, B-U-M-B-L-E-D-O-M. Bumbledom means a lot of official transactions and a lot of bureaucracy, totally a bungling. So Bumbledom means a lot of confusion and bungling up things. So neologism means coining new words, coinage. A neophyte is a recent convert or a beginner. Nepotism means favoring relatives. Nether means lower. When you are nettled by someone, that means you are annoyed and vexed. Nexus means a connection. A nib is the beak of a bird or the point of a pen. A nicety means precision or minute distinction. Niggardly means very mean, stingy, parsimonious, and miserly. Niggle means to spend too much time on minor points. Carp and find faults. People who are niggling are busy finding faults for minor things. A nihilist is one who considers traditional beliefs as groundless and existence meaningless. He is an absolute skeptic and a revolutionary terrorist. Nihilists believe in destruction. Nip means to stop something's growth or development in the bud itself. Snipping. Nirvana is in Buddhist teachings salvation. Nocturnal means moving at night. The antonym is diurnal, which means occurring during day. Noisome smell means something that is foul smelling, unwholesome, rotten. Antonym should be redolent, which means fragrant. Nomadic means wandering. Nomenclature means the terminology. Nominal amount means very small in name only and trifling. Nonchalant means insouciant, which means indifference or lack of concern. The antonym should be solicitous, S-O-L-I-C-I-T-I-O-U-S. Solicitous means very concerned and anxious. Non-committal means neutral, unpledged, undecided, not committing to any side. Nondescript means undistinctive, ordinary, something that cannot be classified. Non-entity means a person of no importance, a cipher, C-I-P-H-E-R. Non-plus means to confuse, perplex, or muddle somebody up. Nostalgia means homesickness or longing for the past. A nostrum is a quack remedy, a questionable cure or a medicine, questionable medicine. Notable means conspicuous and important. Notoriety means disrepute, infamy. Novelty means something new and newness. A novice is a beginner. Noxious fumes are harmful and deleterious, bad for health. A nuance is a fine shade of difference in meaning or color. A subtle distinction is called a nuance. Nubile means of marriageable age, especially of a girl. Negatory value means worthless, futile, useless. To nullify something is to make it invalid. A numismatist is a person who collects coins. Nuptial or connubial means pertaining to marriage. Nurture something means to nourish, educate, and foster. A nutrient is a nourishing substance. An oaf, O-A-F, is a lout, L-O-U-T, a stupid, awkward, and clumsy person who is totally graceless. Obdurate people are stubborn. An obeisance is something like a namaste, a bow, a greeting in respect, which reveals your reverence. A novelisk is a tall column tapering and ending in a pyramid. Obese means excessively fat, that is corpulent, C-O-R-P-U-L-E-N-T. An antonym is emaciated, E-M-A-C-I-A-T-E-D, which means very thin. Obfuscate means to confuse, muddle, or cause confusion. An obituary is a death notice. Objective means not influenced by emotions, which also means fair. The antonym is subjective. Objective also means a goal or an aim. Obligatory duties are binding. That means required, necessary. The antonym is optional. Oblique means indirect or slanting. Obliterate means to completely destroy, annihilate, extirpate, E-X-T-I-R-P-A-T-E, and uproot or deracinate, D-E-R-A-C-I-N-A-T-E. Deracinate means to uproot a people. Oblivion means obscurity or forgetfulness or the state of being unknown or not known, forgotten. So a synonym for oblivion will be wilderness, W-I-L-D-E-R-N-E-S-S, wilderness. A pioneer is likely to suffer from wilderness. Pioneer means all those people who invented, for example, the person who invented the TV. Do you know the name? Obviously, you don't recollect. So, the pioneer suffers from wilderness, means a state of being forgotten. Wilderness also means an uninhabited place, such as a desert or a forest, where nobody stays. Oblivious. If you are oblivious of your surroundings, you might be in a stupor. Oblivious means unaware, unmindful, and inattentive. Wholly absorbed in something else, such that you are totally unaware of what is happening all around you. Obloquy means slander, disgrace, or infamy. Obnoxious comments are very offensive. Obscure, an obscure passage, means very difficult to understand, unclear, dark, and vague. Obscure also means to darken, make unclear. Obsequious means very slavishly attentive. Servile, sycophantic, dody, and groveling. Obsequy means a funeral ceremony. Obsessive means related to thinking about something constantly, preoccupied with something. Obsidian means black volcanic rock. Obsolete means something that is outdated or pass, P-A-S-S-E, outmoded or demode, D-E-M-O-D-E means outdated. So the antonym will be vogue, V-O-G-U-E. Vogue means fashionable, chic, C-H-I-C, nifty, N-I-F-T-Y, and current, C-U-R-R-E-N-T. Or rakish, R-A-K-I-S-H also. Rakish means stylish. Obstetrician is a physician specializing in delivery of babies. Obstinate people are stubborn, and obstreperous people are boisterous and noisy. When you obtrude yourself on somebody, that means you push forward or intrude, butt in, and enter without permission and barge into a place. Obtrude also means to stick out or extrude. Obtuse people are stupid, blunt, and take a lot of time to understand things. The antonym for obtuse will be keen. Obviate means make unnecessary or get rid of. Obviating the need for another all-rounder in the team. We are already full. So obviate means make unnecessary. Occidental means pertaining to the west. Oriental means pertaining to the east. Occlude means to shut or close. occult means mysterious, secret, or preternatural and supernatural. Oculist is a person, a physician, who specializes in the treatment of the eyes. Odious statements. What an odious comment would mean hateful, vile, evil. Odium means detestation, a source of disgust, hatefulness, disrepute. Odoriferous means giving off an odor. Odorous means also the same, having an odor, smell. Odyssey is a long, eventful journey or a difficult journey. Offensive means attacking, insulting, and distasteful. Offhand means ad lib, casual, unpremeditated, done without preparing, and extempore. Officious means meddlesome, excessively pushy in offering one's services. Obliging means a person who is willing to help you, but when you are officious, you are excessively obliging. You are unnecessarily pushy in trying to offer your services. You are meddlesome. A busybody is officious. Ogle means look amorously or lustily at somebody. Olfactory means pertaining to the sense of smell. Oligarchy means a government by a small group of people. Ominous means threatening, looming. Omnipotent means all-powerful. Omnipresent means universally present. Omniscient means all-knowing. Omnivorous means eating both plant and animal food, devouring virtually everything. Onerous tasks are very burdensome. Onomatopoeia means words formed in imitation of natural sounds. Words like rustle and gargle are illustrations of onomatopoeia. For example, tintinabulation, T-I-N-T-I-N-A-B-U-L-A-T-I-O-N. Tintinabulation means the sound of small bells, tin, 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 tin. So that is tintinabulation. Onslaught means a vicious assault. Onus means a burden, responsibility. Opalescent means iridescent or lustrous, radiating light. Opaque means something that is dark, not transparent. Opiate means a medicine that induces sleep or deadens pain, opium. Opportune means timely, inopportune means untimely. An opportunist is an individual who sacrifices principles for expediency by taking advantage of the circumstances. Opprobrium means shame, infamy, vilification, or dishonor. An optician deals with eyeglasses. Optimist is a person who always looks at the brighter side of things. A foolishly optimistic person is called a Pollyanna, P-O-L-Y-A-N-A. And an antonym for optimist will be pessimist. An excessively pessimistic person is a Cassandra, C-A-S-S-A-N-D-R-A, who is a doomsday prophet, who always predicts disaster. Optional means not compulsory. Optimum means most favorable. If you wait for the optimum moment to act, you may never begin your project. So begin listening to these words now. An optometrist is one who fits glasses to remedy visual defects. Opulence means extreme wealth or luxuriousness and abundance. Opus means work. Magnum opus means the major work of any artist. Oracular means prophetic. Oracle means prophecy or predicting the future. An orator is a public speaker. An oratorio or an oratorio is a dramatic poem set to music. Ordain means to decree or command. Grant orders. Predestined. Preordain means predestined. Ordain means give authority to somebody. Ordaining a priest means give somebody authority to function as a priest. The antonym for ordain therefore can be unfrock, U-N-F-R-O-C-K. Take away the rights of the person who is performing as a priest. An ordeal is a severe trial or affliction, a difficult task. An ordinance is a decree. But ordinance without the I, O-R-D-N-A-N-C-E, means a weapons factory. Ordination means a ceremony conferring holy orders. The candidate for ordination had to meet the bishop. Orgy means a wild, drunken revelry, unrestrained indulgence. The Roman emperors were known for their orgies. Orient means get oneself accustomed. adjust. Orientation, act of finding oneself in society. Disoriented people means those who cannot adjust, or because of the effect of certain drugs, people can get totally disoriented. Orifice is a mouth-like opening or a small opening. Ornate means excessively or elaborately decorated. Synonyms for ornate are Baroque, B-A-R-O-Q-U-E, or Rococo, R-O-C-O-C-O, or something that is highly embellished, E-M-B-E-L-L-I-S-H-E-D. An ornithologist is a person who studies birds. Orthodox people are very conservative, traditional. Orthography means study of correct spelling. The spelling, study of spelling is orthography. Oscillate means to vibrate like a pendulum, waver. Osseous means made of bone or bony, like a bone. Ossify means change or harden or turn into bone. Ostensible means apparently, professed, pretended or obvious. Ostentatious means showy and pretentious, trying to attract attention. Ostracize means to exclude a person from public favor, ban, exile, banish, excommunicate or blackball. B-L-A-C-K-B-A-L-L. Blackballing is a parliamentary procedure of voting somebody out. Ousting power means to expel. Ousting somebody from the throne means to depose, D-E-P-O-S-E. Expel or throw out, drive out. An outlandish outfit, outlandish wear means bizarre, peculiar, unconventional, bohemian, and wacky, W-A-C-K-Y, or weird. Outmoded means no longer stylish, old-fashioned, or pass. Outskirts means the fringes, borders, suburbs. Outspoken, people who are outspoken are candid and blunt. Bluff, B-L-U-F-F. Bluff means outspoken, direct, but friendly. Outstrip means to surpass, outdo, or overtake. When you outwit somebody, you are outsmarting him or tricking him. Ovation means an enthusiastic applause. Salvo, S-A-L-V-O. Salvo means a round of applause. Curtain calls, C-U-R-T-A-I-N. Curtain calls, C-A-L-L-S. Curtain calls means ovation. After a drama or a play is over, and in between the first act and the second act, there might be curtain calls. That means the crowd is applauding and giving an ovation or a salvo. Salvo is a round of clapping. Salvo also means a gunshot. Overbearing attitude means bossy, arrogant, and decisively important. Overweening. Peremptory. P-E-R-E-M-P-T-O-R-Y. Peremptory people are overbearing and dominating. Overt means to open to view. Antonym is covert, C-O-V-E-R-T, which means concealed or secret. Overweening means presumptuous and arrogant. It's a synonym for overbearing. Overwrought means excessively agitated or nervously excited. Ovoid means egg-shaped. A pachyderm is a thick-skinned animal like an elephant. A pacifist is one who is opposed to force and who opposes war. He is an anti-militarist. Pacify means to soothe or make somebody calm and quiet. Subdue. A paean, P-A-E-A-N, is a song of praise or joy. Painstaking labor is something that requires a lot of hard work. Palatable food is something that is agreeable and pleasing to the taste. Palate means the roof of the mouth. Palate also means a sense of taste. The people of Andhra have a very spicy palate, whereas those of Gujarat have a sweet palate. Palatial means magnificent, like a palace. Paleontology means the study of prehistoric life and the study of fossils. Palette, it's a board on which a painter mixes pigments and colors. Palimpsest. A palimpsest is a parchment used for second time after the original writing has been erased. It is a source of information about ancient books. Pall, P-A-L-L, grow tiresome or lose in attraction. The study or listening to wordless can eventually pall and put one to sleep. Pallet, P-A-L-L-E-T, means a small, poor bed. A weary traveler would be more than happy to sleep even on a straw pallet. Palliate means to ease pain. Pallet means pale, wan, and sickly. Palpable means something that can be touched, easily perceptible and tangible. Palpitating means throbbing and fluttering, pulsating. Paltry, a paltry score, is an insignificant, petty, trifling, and very small amount. Pan means to criticize harshly. A panacea is a cure-all, a remedy for all diseases. A panache, he has a panache for social meetings. That means flair or flamboyance. Pandemic means something that is widespread. A pandemonium is a wild tumult, lot of noise, din, and bedlam. Pander to somebody's tastes would mean cater to the low desires of others. A pander, in other words, is a pimp, a person who would supply call girls. Panegyric means formal praise. Panoramic means denoting an unobstructed and complete comprehensive view. Panorama means a wide view. Pantomime is acting without dialogue. Papyrus is ancient paper made from the stem of papyrus plant. The ancient Egyptians were known to be using this. Parable is a short, simple story with a moral. A paradigm is a model, example, or a pattern. Paradigmatic would mean a perfect example. A paradox means something that is apparently contradictory. Like if we say, India is a rich country, but the people are poor. That's a paradoxical situation. A paragon is a symbol of perfection or an example, perfect example of something. Parallelism means state of being parallel or similar. The parameters means the limits or independent variables. Paramount importance means foremost, supreme, and principal. A paramour is an illicit lover. Paranoia means psychosis marked by delusions of grandeur or persecution. Paranoia, simply speaking, is abnormal fear. Paraphernalia is equipment or accouterments and trappings or all the odds and ends. Paraphrasing means to restate a passage in simple words. A parasite is an animal or a plant living on another, a sponge. Parched means extremely dry or very thirsty. Pariah means a social outcast. Parity, pay parity is necessary. That means equality. Parity means equality or close resemblance. Parlance means the language, idiom, or argot, jargon, and cant. Parley means a conference. Parochial views are narrow in outlook, provincial. A parody is a humorous imitation. Synonyms are spoof, takeoff, travesty, burlesque. Paroxysm means a fit or attack of pain, laughter, or rage, paroxysms of anger. Parquet is floor made of wood strips inlaid in mosaic-like pattern. Parrying a blow would mean to ward off a blow, or deflect, evade, dodge, and duck. Parsimony would mean stinginess, excessive frugality. Partial is incomplete, partiality, his inclination or bias. Partisan would mean one-sided, prejudiced, committed to a particular party. Partition is divided into parts. Pass means old-fashioned. Passive means not active, receptive. Pastiche means imitation of another style in musical composition or in writing. A pastiche normally includes bits and pieces from other sources. Pastoral means rural, pertaining to green fields, farmyards, meadows, and ranches. Pathetic, a pathetic sight. A pathetic sight is something that causes sadness. Pathological means diseased or pertaining to disease. Pathos is tender sorrow, pity, or quality in art or literature that produces these feelings. A movie may be full of pathos. Patina means a green crust on old bronze works. Patois, P-A-T-O-I-S. Patois means local or provincial dialect. For example, in Telugu, we have three distinct patois. The Andhra Patois, the Telangana is separate, and the Rayalaseema Telugu. That dialect is different. Patriarch means the father or the ruler of a family or a tribe. Patrician means aristocratic or a nobleman. Patronize means to support. Patronize also means to act superior towards, condescend. And patronize would also mean be a customer. Paucity means shortage. A pauper is a very poor person. A peccadillo is a slight offense. Pecca means fault. So impeccable means faultless. And here peccadillo is a slight offense. Pecuniary means pertaining to money. A pedagogue is a teacher. Pedagogy is the teaching, is the science of teaching or art of education. Pedant means a scholar who spouts his knowledge, who tries to make a display of his book learning. Pedantic is showing off learning. Pedestrian means ordinary, unimaginative, and boring. A pediatrician is a physician specializing in children's diseases. Peerless means having no equal, incomparable. Pejorative terms are negative in connotation. Having pejorative terms have a belittling effect. Pell-mell means confusion or disorderly. Pellucid means transparent or limpid, easy to understand. Penance means self-imposed punishment for a sin or an austerity. Penchant means strong inclination or liking, proclivity and preference. Pendant means something that is hanging down from something else. Pendant also means an ornament, a locket, L-O-C-K-E-T, that is hanging from a necklace. Pendulous means hanging and suspended. Pendulous chandeliers sway in the breeze. Penitent means repentant. Pensive means dreamily thoughtful, and thoughtful with a hint of sadness, contemplative. Penumbra. Penumbra means the partial shadow in an eclipse. Umbra is the dark shadow. Penury means severe poverty. Penury would also mean stinginess. A peon is a landless agricultural laborer or a bond servant. Perceptive means insightful, aware, wise, and keen-minded. Percussion instruments are drums. Drums and all those instruments where animal skins are used or stretched membranes are used, those are called percussion instruments. Perdition means damnation or complete ruin. Peregrination means a journey. Peremptory attitude means demanding and leaving no choice, authoritarian. Perennial rivers are those that are long-lasting. Perfidious, a person who is perfidious is treacherous and disloyal. Perforating something would mean put a hole through it or pierce. Perfunctory means superficial, not thorough, lacking interest, care, or enthusiasm. Perigee means the point of the moon's orbit when it is nearest to the earth. Apogee is the antonym, which means farthest from the earth. The perimeter is the outside boundary, the outer boundary of anything. Peripathetic means walking about and moving. Peripheral means marginal or on the outer side. Periphery means the edge, especially of a round surface. Perjury means swearing falsely under oath, false testimony. It's called perjury, that's a crime. Permeable membranes are penetrable and porous, allowing passage. Pernicious means something that is very destructive. Peroration means the conclusion of an oration. Towards the end of a speech, a speaker will perorate, would mean he might recapitulate and urge the audience to do something. Perpetrate means to commit an offense. Perpetual means something that is everlasting. Perpetuate means make something last, preserve from extinction. Perquisites, any gain or perks which are given above the stipulated salary are called perquisites. Personable, we need some personable staff for our reception. That means attractive. Perspicacious people have keen insight. Penetrating and trenchant, astute-minded people are perspicacious. Perspicuity means clearness of expression, freedom from ambiguity. Perspicuous means plainly expressed, therefore. Pert means impertinent or forward. Pertinacious means stubborn, persistent. Pertinent means something that is relevant, to the point, apt, apposite, apropos, and appropriate. Also, felicitous, which means pertinent or relevant. Perturb means to disturb greatly. Peruse means to read with care. Pervasive is something that is spread throughout. Perverse means stubbornly, wrong-headed, wicked and unacceptable, twisted, warped, crooked. Perversion means corruption, turning from right to wrong. Pessimism is a belief that life is basically bad. Gloomy. People who are pessimistic are always gloomy and looking at the negative side of things. Pestilential means causing a disease or plague, painful or harmful and injurious to health, or injurious to an entire population for that matter. Pestle is a tool for mashing or grinding substances. Petrify means to turn to stone. Petty means something that is trivial, unimportant or very small. Petulant, some people are petulant, which means they are very peevish, easily irritated and touchy, which means they are sensitive. If you are very sensitive, it means you are touchy. That means for the slightest thing that the person might get upset. Pharisaical means pertaining to the Pharisees, who paid scrupulous attention to the tradition but never really followed the spirit of the scripture. So Pharisaical means hypocritical, holier than thou, sanctimonious, sententious, moralizing. Phenomena means observable facts. Philanderer means a faithless lover, a flirt, somebody who is amatory and amorous and concupiscent, which means flirtatious. A philanthropist is an altruist who is a lover of mankind. A philatelist is a stamp collector. A Philistine is an uncultured, uncivilized, and narrow-minded person. Philology means study of language. Phlegmatic people are calm. They are not easily disturbed. They are unruffled, stoic, and stolid. Phobia means a morbid fear, excessive fear. Phoenix, Phoenix, is a symbol of immortality or rebirth. Phoenix is also the name of a mythical bird which rises from its ashes, and therefore Phoenix means something immortal. Phylum means a major classification, second to the kingdom. Kingdom is number one, phylum is number two. Physiognomy means face, or lineaments, which means the features of the face. Physiological means pertaining to the science of the functioning of living organisms. Piebald means having different colors. Mottled, M-O-T-T-L-E-D, or spotted. Pied also means the same thing. Pied means variegated and multicolored or checkered in black and white. The Pied Piper was wearing a dress which was multicolored. Piecemeal means one part at a time, gradually. Piety means devoutness or reverence to God. Pigment means a coloring matter. Pillage means to plunder or maraud. M-A-R-A-U-D means plunder. Pillory. Pillory means to punish by placing in a wooden frame. Pillorying somebody would also mean subjecting him to intense criticism and ridicule. Pine means to languish and decline, becoming weak. Or pining also means longing or yearning for something. Pinion means restrain. They pinioned the prisoner with his arms against his body. Pinion therefore means restrain. A pinnacle is a peak. Pious people are devout and religious. Something piquant is pleasantly tart-tasting and stimulating. A piquant sauce is spicy and sharp. To pick someone would be to irritate and cause resentment. Pick also means to provoke, annoy, or arouse. Piscatorial means pertaining to fishing. A pitfall is a sudden danger, a concealed trap. Pith means the cone or marrow, a sense. Pithy means something that is concise and meaningful, substantial. Meaty. Pittance means a small allowance or a wage, small amount. Pivotal means crucial, critical, or central. Placating somebody would be to pacify and conciliate. A placebo is a harmless sugar pill used as a medicine. Placid means peaceful and calm. Plagiarize means to steal another person's ideas and pass them off as one's own. Plaintive songs are mournful. Plait means braid or intertwine. Plasticity means the ability to be molded, malleable. Platitudes are remarks which are commonplace and trite, banal, lacking originality. Platonic love is purely spiritual and theoretical, without sensual desires. Plaudits are enthusiastic approval or rounds of applause. Something plausible is believable. It also means having a show of truth but open to doubt. Specious, S-P-E-C-I-O-U-S. Specious is plausible. Plebeian means common, pertaining to the common people. A plenary session in the parliament is a full and complete session. Plenitude means abundance and completeness. Plethora is the same as abundance, excess, in fact, overabundance. Pliable things are flexible, yielding, adaptable, and amenable. Pliant means flexible, easily influenced. The plight of the refugees means the condition, the state, especially a bad one. Predicament, P-R-E, D-I-C-A-M-E-N-T. A predicament is an unfortunate situation. Plucky means courageous. Plumage means the feathers of a bird. Plumb means to examine critically or measure the depth of something. Plumb also means vertical. The ball landed plumb on the middle stump means vertical or straight. Plummet means to rapidly fall. Plutocracy is ruled by the people who are wealthy. Podiatrist is a doctor who treats ailments of the feet. A podium is a pedestal, a raised platform. Poignancy, P-O-I-G-N-A-N-C-Y, the G is silent here. Poignancy means the quality of being deeply moving, keenness of emotion. Polarize means to split into opposite extremes, create a sharp rift. Polemics, controversial arguments in support of one's own view. Polemical means aggressive in verbal attack, disputatious. Politic people are expedient, prudent, and well-devised. Polity means a form of government of nation or state. Our polity should be devoted to the concept that the government should strive for the good of all the citizens. A polygamist is one who has more than one spouse. Polyglot means a multilingualist who speaks several languages. Pomposity means self-important behavior, acting like a stuffed shirt, very bombastic and big, putting up a big show. A ponderous text is weighty and unwieldy. Pontifical. Pontiff means a high priest. The Pope is also called a pontiff. Pontifical means pertaining to the duties of a pope or a bishop or a priest for that matter. But pontifical also has a negative meaning, which means pompous and pretentious. Pour, when you pour over the books, that means study industriously, ponder, scrutinize, and study with great lucubration, L-U-C-U-B-R-A-T-I-O-N, which means burning the midnight oil. Porous substances are full of pores like a sieve. Portend means to foretell, presage, board, or serve as an omen. Portent means a sign, an omen, a forewarning. Portly people are stout and corpulent. They are obese, O-B-E-S-E. Posier. A posier is a person who pretends to be sophisticated, elegant, in order to impress others. A poser is different, P-O-S-E-R. A poser means a difficult or baffling question. Posterity means future generations or descendants. Posthumous means after death. A postulate is a self-evident truth, a premise, a hypothesis. Posture means assumed or affected pose. Act artificially. Potable water is suitable for drinking, P-O-T-A-B-L-E. Potent means powerful and persuasive, greatly influential, puissant. Potentate means a monarch or a sovereign, a king, an absolute monarch. Potential means expressing possibility or latent. Potion means a liquid, medicinal liquid. Potpourri, P-O-T-P-O-U-R-R-I, the T is silent. Heterogeneous mixture or a medley. Poultice means a soothing application applied to sores or inflamed portions of the body. Usually a towel dipped in hot water or a towel simultaneously dipped in cold water acts as a poultice. Practicable means feasible or viable. Practical means based on experience, useful. Pragmatic people are very practical, opposed to quixotic. Q-U-I-X-O-T-I-C. Quixotic means foolishly idealistic. A pragmatist is a practical person. Prate means to speak foolishly or boast idly. Prattle is babble, gibberish, nonsensical talk. Preamble means an introductory statement. A precarious position means uncertain, risky, and lacking balance. Precedent is something preceding in time that may be used as an authority or a guide for future action. A precedent, therefore, is an example set for others to follow. Precedent means preceding in time and rank. Precept means a practical rule for guiding conduct. A precipice is a cliff or a dangerous position. A precipitant is something that causes a substance in a chemical solution to separate out in solid form. A precipitant also means something that quickens the action. Precipitate in a precipitate mood, that means rash, premature, hasty and sudden. Precipitate also means hasten or throw headlong, go rashly into something. Precipitous fall means a steep fall. Precise writing is concise summing up of main points. Precise means exact. To preclude something would be to make it unnecessary, impossible or eliminate. Precocious children are advanced in development. They are called wunderkind. W-U-N-D-E-R-K-I-N-D. Wunderkind or a whiz. W-H-I-Z. A prodigy. P-R-O-D-I-G-Y.